The world of finance has always something super, super interesting for us to see. Today, we are going to discuss something that absolutely blew our minds. Modern portfolio theory, that's a theory that we read in CA finals also, strategic financial management mein bhi padhte hain hum log. And that theory is being used to better coral reefs, to save them, and to materially impact climate change. Let's dive deeper today into this story that was covered by The Guardian. And it's absolutely mind-blowing. We'll start with explaining what the modern portfolio theory is, and then we'll see isko apply kaise kiya in climate change and to save these coral reefs.
But Shantanu, coral reefs ko save kyu karna hai hume?
That's a very, very good question, and I think that context apne readers ko bhi hona chahiye.
Mm-hmm.
Ki coral reefs are basically only 0.2% of the ocean, right? And wo aisa dikhta hai, this is what coral reefs actually look like. And these actually have 25% of marine life. 0.2% of ocean bed has 25% of marine life. And isse millions of people ka livelihood hai. The people who are catching fish or who are doing marine activities, etc. Inke livelihoods are attached to this. That's why this becomes super, super important.
But I think more than the livelihood of people, it is also very important for the supply, for the food chain.
Har cheez ke liye supply chain nahi.
Haan, food chain.
Right.
School mein padhate the na ki food chain start hota hai small bodies se and then it goes to us. So I think those small bodies all have their source in oceans. So that is really important for.
हाँ करेक्ट, वो पूरा पूरा इकोसिस्टम ही ब्रेक होता है. एंड एनीबॉडी हु अंडरस्टैंड्स क्लाइमेट चेंज अंडरस्टैंड्स की दैट क्रिएट्स अ होल डोमिनो इफेक्ट व्हेन यू मूव इवन अ स्मॉल इकोसिस्टम इन द एनवायरनमेंट. सो एब्सोल्युटली राइट, बट विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी मोर टाइम लेट्स जस्ट डाइव डीपर इनटू व्हाट द मॉडर्न पोर्टफोलियो थ्योरी इज, बिकॉज अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट इज ऑल्सो सुपर इम्पॉर्टेंट. एंड देन उसका एप्लीकेशन इसमें कैसे है, कोरल रीफ्स को बचाने में कैसे है. So I'll just use a simple graph to explain this. What modern portfolio theory talks about is that you can create a portfolio of assets or investments or stocks basically,
mm-hmm.
to get a certain level of return against mm-hmm. a certain level of risk. So basically hum log kya bolte hain ki hamare financial world mein that higher the risk higher the return,
mm-hmm.
right, or higher the expected return. But say I have stocks, and let's use examples here, jinka returns, and yahan pe main risk bhi le leta hu. So say a government bond, right?
Mm-hmm.
Uska risk will be 0%, but it's giving me 6%.
Huh.
But I'm somebody who wants, I do my financial planning and I do every analysis that is possible,
mm-hmm.
right? And I figure out ki nahi yaar, mujhe at least 12% to over a period of time returns chahiye, right?
Mm-hmm.
By doing whatever back calculations and all I do. I find another stock that gives 10% of return, but uska volatility is also 10%. Risk is basically volatility in the
uh-huh.
markets, right? So uska standard deviation is also say 10%.
Okay.
Okay. So this line denotes standard deviation or risk.
Okay.
And this is the expected return.
Okay.
Clean hai na ekdam.
Mm-hmm. Let me suggest the cryptos le lo.
So. Yeah, so say crypto, somebody's, we also have another asset class that is a 30% kind of a return.
30% se zyada hi hai.
Yeah, but let's say, and risk is also, let's say 50% up down hota hai. We are just reducing random numbers.
Uh-huh.
Right? So yahan pe dikh raha hai, higher the risk, higher the return wala principle follow kar raha hai.
Uh-huh.
Now using this bouquet of stocks, assume ki world mein yahi teen available hain,
uh-huh.
right? And you want to have an average return of 12%.
Okay.
So what is the kind of risk that you will need to bear? And what should be your portfolio mix? This is what this theory tells you,
okay.
right? So what happens is, jinhone ye theory banayi, they said that there can exist a bunch of portfolios for you to meet your desire, your favorable return, your favorable expected return. So right now, say my expected return is 12%. Now, mm-hmm. how do I construct my portfolio so that I get this 12% of return,
okay.
right? So, isko apan plot karte hain graph pe, 0, yahan pe 6, यहाँ पे लेट्स अज्यूम 10 है एंड दिस इज नॉट टू स्केल गाइस, दिस इज 30%, दिस इज 10% एंड लेट्स से दिस इज 6% एंड देन वी हैव ऑन द रिस्क साइड 0%, 10% एंड लेट्स से यहाँ पे कहीं पे 50%, राइट? नाउ यू प्लॉट, तो 30 to 50 ये वाला आएगा. आई विल एक्सप्लेन व्हाई वी आर प्लॉटिंग दिस ऑल्सो. 10 and 10 पे यहाँ पे कहीं पे कुछ आएगा. दिस इज नॉट टू स्केल गाइस, हाँ प्लीज डोंट होल्ड मी फॉर दैट. एंड 0 to 6 का यहाँ पे आएगा.
ठीक है.
तो यू क्रिएट दिस डॉटेड लाइन, राइट? दिस इज समथिंग दैट वी कॉल द एफिशिएंट फ्रंटियर. दिस इज द एफिशिएंट फ्रंटियर. नाउ सी, व्हेन यू गो इसके नीचे ना, इस फ्रंटियर के नीचे व्हाट विल हैपन इज, से यू एक्सपेक्ट अ रिटर्न ऑफ 10%, राइट? यू कैन गेट दिस एट अ 10% रिस्क. अभी बोलो यहाँ पे कोई पोर्टफोलियो है,
हाँ.
या फिर सॉरी यहाँ पे कोई पोर्टफोलियो है, राइट? अब इस पोर्टफोलियो का ऑब्वियसली रिटर्न इज 10% ओनली, इज इक्वल टू दिस, बट इट हैज अ हायर रिस्क,
सो ऑब्वियसली आई वोंट चूज दैट ऑप्शन.
करेक्ट. सो द मॉडर्न पोर्टफोलियो थ्योरी अज्यूम्स दैट पीपल आर रिस्क अवर्स, दैट फॉर द सेम, फॉर अ हायर लेवल ऑफ रिस्क दे विल एक्सपेक्ट हायर रिटर्न्स, बट फॉर द सेम लेवल ऑफ रिटर्न they will try and minimize the risk as much as possible.
Absolutely.
So 10% में उसको ये जमेगा. But मेरा expectation of return is 12%. So that will be somewhere around here. Correct? So my risk will be, and if we solve for x in this equation, my risk will also be 10% से थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा.
But Shantanu, tell me, ये तो you told me if I choose a point within the frontier, what if I choose a point outside the frontier? वो भी तो पॉसिबल है, एंड इट विल गिव मी मोर रिटर्न एट लेस रिस्क.
यस, बट दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज दैट इज नॉट इन द फ्रेम ऑफ स्टॉक्स. हैड देयर बीन समथिंग दैट वाज गिविंग रिटर्न्स एट अ हायर रिस्क, वी वुड हैव प्लॉटेड दैट आल्सो ऑन द ग्राफ.
ओह आई सी, राइट? हां, गॉट इट.
सो दिस इज राइट हियर, वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट देयर आर ओनली 3 स्टॉक्स इन द वर्ल्ड.
ओके, गॉट इट.
अदरवाइज यू कैन टेक 50 स्टॉक्स का आल्सो, रैंक देम, स्टैक रैंक देम, फिगर आउट कि उसका रिस्क रिटर्न रेशियो क्या है, एंड देन क्रिएट दिस frontier line.
Ah, okay, got it.
Efficient frontier. Okay? So ab now if somebody wants to solve for x, I'll be happy to do that for you, but bahut hi simple hai, and you guys can tell me in the comments also ki kitna risk expected hona chahiye for a person who wants a 12% kind of a return, right? Obviously intuitively samajh mein aata hai ki kuch paise wo isme laga sakte hain, kuch paise isme bhi laga sakte hain, and kuch paise isme bhi laga sakte hain. It can be zero, something, something. It can be something zero something.
Correct.
Right? It can not be this only. Haan. Obviously, otherwise the risk will be too high. So intuitively we understand that, but you can solve for x also. I'll drop an equation also here, where what we want is 10% of x plus 30% of 1 minus x. Because 100% hi ho sakta portfolio, so other nahi, is equal to 12%. Right?
Basic algebra, and
when,
no?
Yes, and when we calculate for x, we then just need to apply that to this risk. So usse apne ko risk ka bhi percentage samajh mein aa jayega ki this is the average risk of my portfolio.
Got it.
Absolutely clear. Haan. So the whole idea of the modern portfolio theory is that people want to minimize risk, people want to maximize returns. There are a bunch of this is called the efficient frontier. Why? Because from a bouquet of 50,000 assets that you can invest in, there will be a certain number of assets basis this permutation and combination that will be very efficient for you in terms of risk and return.
Okay, got it.
Yes, and now its application in climate change, intuitively what we'll understand is ki climate change is a risk, right?
Okay.
The risk is being quantified as coral reefs ka depletion.
Okay.
So that's the risky. Okay, what are the root causes of the depleting coral reef?
Okay.
Right? And they are, as we'll read in the article, they are global warming, fishing activities jo ho rahi hai, excessive fishing activities, wastages jo ja rahe hai in these water bodies, fertilizers and all.
Pollution.
So these become root causes, right?
Okay.
And then what they're trying to do is find out that set of reefs that they can save, right, and have in the best possible way, which is basically kinko bachaya ja sakta hai least effort mein and maximum return jinse mile. So they now know ki hum sare reefs to nahi bacha sakte,
Okay.
So which are those top 50 reefs where if we put effort in saving them, right, they have a higher probability of being saved also.
Okay.
You get it?
Salvaging the situation basically.
Exactly. It's like मेरे 10 बच्चे हैं, सबसे ज़्यादा probability किसका अमीर बनने का है या मुझे किस में इन्वेस्ट करके अच्छे से मैं अपना फ्यूचर हेज कर पाऊंगा. So you understand that intuitively now, right? So that's the whole point of this this article. What was beautiful was applying this concept into a climate change वाला scenario. And let's now dive deeper into how they're trying to identify these 50 reefs or coral sanctuaries around the world that are most likely to survive the climate change crisis and be able to repopulate other reefs.
Oh.
So that which, and this is super, super sad for us as a species also, that we've created so much chaos that now we need to find a way to efficiently select only 50 reefs and save at least them. Ki bhai kuch to bachega. So they're recommending, so it's very, very interesting. And
it's
what,
like Noah's Ark. You're just gathering every species and then trying to use that to repopulate.
But in a very, very scientific way, using a lot of probability, where you see ki kaun se wale species ko utha ke unka reproductive rate maximum ho sakta hai. I mean, I'm just thinking out loud here. And the gains are obviously, they're measuring the gains also because expected return वगैरह सोच रहे हैं. तो the gains go beyond positive ecological outcomes, including crucial social, economic, health, nutritional benefits for communities. So they are using all of these parameters to define returns, कि उनसे returns क्या मिलेंगे, and they are using certain set of parameters to define the risks
risk
जो
also.
उसमें.
Okay.
And there are Blue Earth consultants and all also who are helping them out. So a climate change scientist is saying that it is essentially a strategy to help us make decisions about what to protect if we are to have corals at the end of this century. And this is what's causing the problem, that ensured global heating was limited to 1.5 degree in the pre-industrial level. Reductions drastically reduce karne padenge, which means ki hume almost half karna padega pura global CO2 emissions.
Oh.
And uske baad bhi 70 to 90% of today's corals would vanish. Yeah, exactly. So it's a very, very pathetic situation now, and we're just trying our best to find ki wo efficient portfolio of reefs kaun se hain which we can save. And this is what a reef looks like actually. 14% has been lost globally in less than a decade, with bleaching events caused by rising sea temperatures, which is global warming directly. So modern portfolio theory is a framework that aims to reduce risk while maximizing returns, which we explained. इसके पहले, राइट, इट इज अबाउट क्रिएटिंग अ बैलेंस्ड पोर्टफोलियो, नॉट एवरीथिंग इन अ रिस्क फ्री एसेट, नॉट एवरीथिंग इन क्रिप्टोस, बट अ बैलेंस्ड पोर्टफोलियो. ऐसा नहीं कि सिर्फ जो जिसका हाईएस्ट प्रोबेबिलिटी है, जो सेफेस्ट ऑफ सेफ 10 है, उसी को बचा ले. नहीं, शायद कुछ ऐसे भी हैं जिनमें थोड़ा सा रिस्क इन्वॉल्व है बट उसका पोटेंशियल पे ऑफ विल बी मच हायर. एंड वो कैसे मेजर कर रहे हैं, दैट ऑल्सो बिकम्स इंपॉर्टेंट, कि यार मेजर कैसे करोगे. आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड द यूजर्स who are viewing this, they'll be thinking, yaar, measure kaise karenge is cheez ko, because that was a question that I had also. So uske liye bhi they're creating these BCUs, bioclimatic units, to measure, which is basically har 500 square kilometer mein world ke reefs ko divide kar rahe hain.
Okay.
And for this they are using 174 metrics in 5 categories, including temperature, ocean acidification, invasive species like ours, cyclone activity and connectivity to other reefs. Ki wo andar se kaise connected and all. So they're using this and they're trying to kind of maximize this, like we maximize returns on our stock, right? And they use MPT to quantify the threats. The biggest problem for them abhi tak was ki quantification nahi samajh mein aa raha. How do you quantify these things?
Exactly.
Right? Because surface level pe to dekh ke bahut samajh mein aa jata hai, but thanks to modern technologies, data collection capabilities and data analytics capabilities and simulation capabilities, we'll be able to do this. Otherwise it wouldn't have been possible.
It's ironic, agar ye technology develop nahi hota to they would have been safe as it is.
Not really, because you're assuming that technology could have only been built had there been industrial revolution. Without that, technology would never have been built.
Yes,
that is a philosophical debate that we can have, but that's more about hyper capitalism. There are economies that have developed without harming the environment so much, right? US, China were the ones who absolutely went berserk in the industrialization age, right?
I believe the probability of somebody going that way, somebody going rogue, is very high. Agar US, China nahi hota, there would have been somebody else.
Yes, there would have been, but assuming that, definitely it would have played out in the other way around, that we wouldn't have reached where we are today had we taken some other path, is very, very, I mean, there could have been a billion possibilities, right? It's just a pipe. It's just us musing about things.
Okay.
We can't certainly say that. It is a possibility, not a high probability.
Okay.
But yeah, ye cut karna padega, I think. But we can keep also. But yes, so yeah, we get philosophical also when we are discussing these things. You don't want to put all your eggs in one basket, and that's what probably they're trying to do. And that's what probably modern portfolio theory also says. And people who are watching this, you can apply this to your stock picking things also, right? Don't put all your eggs in one basket. And startup investing, agar koi kar raha hai jo bhi bahut hi chala hua hai, toh then that also is something where you can apply this. So the project identified reefs across a lot of different places. And sabse bada cheez hai that this will need money, right? And nearly $93 million has been invested in the project that these folks are working on. And the report found that 50 reefs inspired approach has helped at least 26 organizations, and 8 funders have now prioritized 60 coral reef ecosystem across more than 40 countries.
Wow.
Yes. I'm just thinking that aisa ek point, again getting philosophical, but there might come a point when we can apply these to our own species also in some way or the other.
We might have to, who knows?
That at the end, if we have exhausted a lot of resources, we might have to apply a modern portfolio theory approach to save, to figure out which species, which citizens to save.
In fact, I think we might have to use this theory to decide kisko Mars pe leke jaate hai, kisko nahi leke jaate hai.
That can be a very, very interesting, that who will be the potentially the people who will give maximum returns when we move to Mars, and in the least risky way.
There's an
Elon
episode.
Musk, if you're listening to this, please use the modern portfolio theory for deciding who's going to Mars, and we hope that we are part of that 50 wala. So coral reefs cover just 0.2% of the ocean floor, as we discussed, and they have around 1/4 of the marine species, which is 25% of the marine species. And one of the biggest benefits of 50 approach has been this compelling message that climate change is the critical threat to coral reefs, and this is an approach that can give reefs a fighting chance. They're not even talking about saving everything. They're not even talking about a surety of success. They're just talking about a fighting chance. And I think this will be a fighting chance for humanity itself. If that food chain is destroyed, we don't know how it will impact the food chain. And probably there is research done on that, and we might dig deeper into it. But I have absolutely no clue how it will impact.
No idea.
And using this technique, they found a no-take marine protected area between Kenya and Tanzania, in which no fishing, mining, drilling, etc. is being done. And this has been supported by WSC, which was on top of it, to protect the corals from these pressures running alongside global warming, right? They're not only trying to save coral reef diverse biodiversity, but also the whales, dolphins, and other marine life that's around them, that's dependent on them for food, etc. And one of these 50 reefs that has been identified is actually called the Happy Coral Reef, where some coral species have survived despite global warming.
Okay.
So they can be used as test subjects for the other, saving the other coral reefs. So guys, the essence of this video was to give you a perspective on how different theories can be implemented in very different ways also, that there can be multiple applications of the same thing. And it's up to us on how many mental models do we carry with us. And as students, as folks who are in your early days of maybe college education or even your careers, I think it's very important to carry a lot of mental models. Right, figuring out, okay, ye mental model kahan fix ho sakta hai. You never really know where you can apply them and create a very, very huge impact.
इट्स अबाउट कीपिंग आर माइंड ओपन दैट इस सब्जेक्ट का यूज़ क्या होगा, हम अभी क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं. यू माइट नॉट रियलाइज दिस नाउ बट अंडरस्टैंड दैट कॉन्सेप्ट, मे बी समटाइम इन द फ्यूचर यू विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई इट.
एब्सोल्युटली. एंड ऑन दैट नोट, थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग इन. डू सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल. आई होप यू लाइक इट. दिस इज मी शांतनु जैन एंड दिस इज यवंतिका माई को फाउंडर, एंड स्टे ट्यून्ड टू रीड ऑन.
बाय.